Hello and welcome! Grafana Champion is here. My name is Daria Volkova and this channel helps utilize Grafana to its full potential. Today I want to break down a solution that answers many of the community's questions. I will create this dashboard. You can upload a file into a database and then review all previously uploaded files. The solution combines three open source plugins: Data Manipulation, Variable Panel and Base64 Panel. Are you ready to be blown away by how simple it is to set up? Let's go! All right, as I mentioned, I will use these open source plugins: Data Manipulation, Variable Panel, and Base64 Panel. Before I continue, I want to clarify that this video is not a comprehensive tutorial on each plugin. I have plenty of videos on this channel where I outline concepts and major features. Look for the links in the description box below. So, this video demonstrates how to incorporate three plugins to deliver for a highly demanded business requirement, namely file upload and file review. For the file upload, I will explain two approaches. One connects to a Grafana data source and the other uses the external HTTP API server. I start by creating a table in the PostgreSQL database. We use PostgreSQL frequently in our projects, and I explain the reasoning behind that in this blog post. My table will consist of two columns, file name and file body. All files are going to be stored in the Base64 string format. Once the table is created, I switch to Grafana to perform all other steps. In Grafana, I begin with configuring my PostgreSQL data source. Go to Connections, then Add New Data Source, and select PostgreSQL. Name PostgreSQL, host URL Postgres, port 5432. I use the default database so the database name parameter can remain unpopulated. Username Postgres, then specify the password. TLS SSL mode is set to Disable. Save and test. The database connection is okay. Next, on the new dashboard, add visualization. Select the data manipulation panel from the list. I use this panel to send data back to the database. I do not need to retrieve anything. That means the data source on the left does not play any role and can be anything. I set it to Grafana. Next, I go to the form elements section. For a new element, enter ID, let's say file. Label it upload file, type file, then add element button. With that, I can see the file element on the form here, and on the left, I can open the element for more parameters. In the accept box, I enter PNG and PDF to limit the files my project will allow users to upload. Click save and apply. So far, so good. I will need this form twice to demonstrate two approaches to file upload. So from here, I open the context menu, more, and then duplicate. Now I can configure the first panel to use data source. Go to edit mode, change the title to data source upload as Base64, then go to the update request section. Here I specify if changed. That instructs the form to enable the submit button when a user makes any changes. In my case, when a user uploads a file. Set the update action to data source. With that, two more options appear: the data source and update request payload. Here I choose PostgreSQL, the data source that I configured earlier. In the update request payload, I change the request payload to code, and in the create payload, I paste the code which converts the uploaded file to the Base64 string and then sends it to the database's files table. The JavaScript specified in the custom code executes after the update request. I will keep the default code for this project. Our documentation has this data flow section, which contains a schema outlining the timing of all JavaScript codes of the data manipulation plugin. It is an excellent source for learning about the timing of all JavaScript options. Save, apply. Now I can click on the upload file element, select a file, then upload and submit button to start uploading. The OK green message is the first good sign. Alright, I have a new row in my PostgreSQL database. The file name I selected and the body has been converted into the Base64 format. The insert is working. The configuration of the data manipulation plugin using DataSource is complete. Next, let's see how to configure the data manipulation with the HTTP API server. Obviously, you need the HTTP server for this method. I pre-configured mine in this URL address. The link to the code I used in the description box below. Now go to Edit mode. Change the title. Expand the Update Request section. Set the Enable Update to If Changed, the same as for the first panel. For the Update action, specify Post. With that, I have an option to enter an HTTP API URL address. Ensure that you select an appropriate content type, multi-part form data. The same story applies to the custom code. I keep what is here by default. For the Update Request payload, I can choose all elements or update it only. My form contains only one element, so these two options have the same meaning. Save and apply. Let's do some testing. Click the Upload file, select a file and Upload button, then Submit on the dashboard. Nothing else yet to see on the dashboard, so I check the database. The second row has appeared, meaning the file has been uploaded. At this point, two of my data manipulation forms are configured. I'm ready for the next step, the variable panel. I go to Dashboard Settings, Variables, Add a Variable, Type, Query, Variable Name. Name, nothing for Show on Dashboard. The Data Source PostgreSQL query, select name from the files table. Run Query button. These are the names of two files I already uploaded to the database. Go back to the dashboard, add, visualization, select the variable panel from the list. This panel will use the pre-configured dashboard variable as a source. Thus, there is no need for a data source. I can have anything here. In the layout section, I select the dashboard variable name. Immediately after, I can see all the uploaded files on the dashboard. In the variable section, I select button for display mode. That changes how the panel looks on the dashboard. Save, apply, adjust. The last panel to configure is the Base64. Go to Add, select Base64 from the list. The data source is going to be my PostgreSQL. The query, select file from files table where name equal the current dashboard variable. On the left, the field name is file. That's it. Save and apply. Adjust the panel's positions. Let's upload the file one more time. I select a PDF now. Once the file is uploaded, the variable panel will update on the fly and show the name of the newly loaded file. The Base64 panel also displays the latest uploaded file. I can click on any other name to see the different files. To summarize, today I provided the tutorial on uploading a file into your database using a data source or HTTP API server and displaying the uploaded files using the variable panel and Base64 plugin. You can find the same tutorial on this blog post on our website volkoflabs.io/blog. Feel free to ask any questions in the comment section below. In addition to the videos, we keep the plugins documentation current. Please check it out for plugins basics and descriptions of all options. That is all for now. Thank you for watching and see you next time.